Matched pairs design. Matching the subject in various ways can produce more precise results than simple randomization. The simplest use of matching is a matched pairs design, which compares just two treatments. The subjects are matched in pairs, okay? The idea is that matched subjects are more similar than unmatched subjects, so that comparing responses within a number of pairs is more efficient than comparing the responses of groups of randomly assigned subjects. Randomization remains important. Which one of the matched pair use the first treatment is decided at random. One common variation of the matched pair design imposes both treatments on the same subject. When this is the case, we call this is the same sample measured twice, so that each subject serves as his or her own control. Okay. The theoretical part is kind of dry, so let's look at some concrete example. Okay. Example, an educator developed a new learning method and wanted to prove it is better than the traditional one, old method. How can he design an experiment? Look at design three, okay? The design three is randomly select 100 people and randomly assign 50 of them into what? Treatment group, and the rest 50 go to what? Huh? Control group. New method, treatment one group is what? Using new method. People, students join what? Treatment one. They're going to use what? New learning method. And the rest, student join the second group, okay? Use old method, use treatment two, okay? A completely randomized design. What is completely randomized design, okay? This is a concept I'm going to explain next. But before that, please what? Read the paragraph from here to here again, okay? Let's look at the definition of what? Completely randomized design, okay? What is completely randomized design? CRE, okay? Completely randomized design is one where the treatments are assigned completely at random, so that each experimental unit, okay, each experimental unit has the same chance of receiving what? Any treatment. For the concrete randomized design, any differences among experimental units receive the same experiment is considered as experimental error. What does that mean? Okay. Say I have four people. Okay. Say they are John, Peter, Mary, and Ruby. Okay, four different person, and there are two treatment, okay? Let's use the early what example. Treatment one, use the new what? New learning method. And treatment two, use the old method, the traditional one, okay? A completely randomized design, that means the design. In this case, the experimental unit and experimental unit is a subject, okay? So we have four experimental units. In experimental design, when experimental units are human beings, we usually call them subjects. So we have four subjects in this experiment, okay? Each subject, okay? If this is completely randomized design, we have two different treatments. If this is a completely randomized design, that means John have 50% chance to get treatment one, to join what? The new method. Also have 50% chance to join what? The old method. Same probability to what? To Peter. People have 50% chance join the new method or 50% chance join old method. Same for Mary. For each individual in the experiment, since we have two treatment methods, each person has exactly what? 50% chance to get treatment one, also 50% chance to get treatment two. This is called completely randomized design, okay? So think about if we have what? We have three different treatments, then each person has what? 1/3 chance to receive what? Different treatment, okay? Equally likely, that's called completely randomized design, okay? Okay, let me talk a little bit more. What in our example, if we have four subjects, okay? These four subjects are our four experimental units. First person, John. The chance that John received treatment one is equal to the chance that John received treatment two. Both equal to 50% because I have only what? Two possible treatments. Each individual received what? Treatment one, treatment two, equally likely, 50% chance. And not just for John, for Peter, for Mary, for Ruby, they are all the same. This is called completely randomized design, okay? Now please look at here. Suppose Peter receiving treatment one is 1/3, Peter received treatment two is 2/3. That means Peter is more likely to get what? Treatment two. You see the difference, right? John received treatment one, chance is 1/2. Peter received treatment one is only 1/3. There is a difference between 1/2 and 1/3. This difference is called what? It's called experimental error, okay? Look at the sentence. For the concrete randomized design, any difference among experimental units receiving the same treatment is considered experimental error. Look at here. John received treatment one. Peter received treatment one. There is a difference. John is 50%. Peter is what? 1/3. This is called experimental error. Okay?